investigations are continuing tonight into the deaths of two men on a drilling rig in the Bass Strait. Alicia Morrison is in Melbourne. Alicia, do we know exactly what happened yet?
Well, Hermione, both men were working on a natural gas drill rig offshore from Port Campbell in Victoria's southwest. Now, the pair, it's believed, were trying to fix a drill when apparently the machinery bounced back because of pressurised gas hitting both of the men. One unfortunately died on site, the other en route to hospital. They've since been confirmed as a 32-year-old man from the Northern Territory and a 60-year-old man from Scotland. Now, as a result of the accident, that's triggered the evacuation of the rest of the workers from the rig back to shore in Victoria. Detectives have then flown across from Victoria to site where they'll prepare a report for the coroner. Now, one of the men was an employee for Origin Energy, the other for Stena Drilling. Now, the Stena Clyde drill rig is only about 60 to 70 metres wide and has been operating since about March, where they're trying to find natural gas on behalf of Origin Energy. And because this accident happened offshore, it won't be investigated by WorkSafe. Instead, by industry safety body NOPSEMA, and Origin Energy has also quickly moved to assure the community there'll be no environmental issues as a result of this unfortunate incident.
Okay, thank you to Alicia Morrison in Melbourne. Australians are being warned to be vigilant with flu prevention measures after the death of a Queensland mother. Chloe Baker joins us live from Brisbane now. Chloe, there was hope Katrina Day would pull through.
Yeah, Hermione, this is just such a heartbreaking case. Katrina Day was a fit, healthy, active mother of four. The 38-year-old went to her doctor thinking she was suffering from the common flu. She was told to go home, take cold and flu medication and rest up. But 5 weeks since that visit to the doctor, the 38-year-old has since died. Now, she contracted the deadly strain of influenza A, which is going around at the moment. It attacks the heart and vital organs, and it left Katrina susceptible to bacteria. Her grieving husband says he now wants to raise as much money as he can to buy more specialised equipment, which helped keep Katrina alive for those extra 5 weeks and gave her some precious time with her four young children. He says he wants her to be remembered as the fit and healthy, loving mother that she was. Katrina was in fact just one of five patients in the Prince Charles Hospital here in Brisbane in intensive care with influenza A. Out of those five patients, three, including Katrina, are now dead. Hermione?
Thank you, Chloe Baker in Brisbane. And Matt will have more on this story shortly. Darren Hinch is in shock after his sacking from radio station 3AW tonight. The Human Headline says he finished his Melbourne program thinking it was one of his best, only to be told the news his contract wasn't going to be renewed.
This time last year, I didn't think I'd be alive today to get fired. So on that note, it's pretty good. I mean, I'm still here. I'm still standing. I'll do something, you know. You can't kill weeds. I'll bounce back. I don't know what I'll do, but it's not the end of Hinch. I'll be back.
Hinch will remain on air until the end of the year. Tony Abbott is distancing himself from a former Prime Minister's call for the return of individual work agreements. Amanda Hart joins us live from Canberra. Amanda, could work choices be coming back?
Well, Hermione, the government says you can bet your bottom dollar under Tony Abbott, work choices will be coming back. This comes after John Howard reignited the work choices debate at a business forum last week. Now, industrial relations isn't a strong point for the coalition. Cast your mind back to 2007, and John Howard basically lost that election because of work choices. Tony Abbott said before the 2010 election that it was dead, buried and cremated. Now, at the moment, this is really the last thing that Tony Abbott needs, because polling out today shows that the coalition support is dropping slightly, and Julie Gillard has just nudged ahead as preferred Prime Minister. Let's go and have a listen now to what John Howard said and Tony Abbott's reaction to it.
There's no reason why this country should not go back to the workplace system we had between 1996 and 2005.
John Howard is three Liberal leaders ago. That was then. This is now. There is no going back to the past.
And news just in, Hermione, an asylum seeker boat has been intercepted near Christmas Island. It was carrying 165 people. This is the second boat to arrive in the past 24 hours. The second one had 77 people on board, and there is a real possibility they could be sent to Nauru for processing.
Okay, thank you to Amanda Hart in Canberra. Holden is offering free inspections after recalling more than 50,000 imported cars. It's withdrawn four models, the Captiva, Barina, Epica and Viva, built between 2007 and 2010. The company says corrosion of components may cause spongy brake performance. The problem hasn't been identified yet in Australia, but the company is offering free checks with Holden dealers. Police are confident of catching a cross-dressing bandit who held up a service station near Geelong in Victoria. Staff at the Lara service station didn't realise that she was in fact a he until he produced a large kitchen knife and demanded cash and cigarettes. Security vision shows the bizarre robbery in such clear detail that detectives are sure the culprit will be recognised. Robotic surf lifesavers could be rolled out across the country if a Sydney trial proves successful. Remote-controlled buoys will be used at the city's busiest beaches. They can reach swimmers 12 times faster than a person.
We'll be putting it through a trial process, testing it on our beaches and seeing how it can be used in the Australian context as best as we can.
Unmanned drones with cameras on board will also be trialled to keep an eye out for rips and sharks. And keepers at Adelaide Zoo are confident next year they'll have more success with breeding their star attractions. Giant pandas Wang Wang and Fu Ni were locked away for a weekend of playtime, but keepers didn't get the result they were hoping for. They'll have to wait another year to try again and may need the help of artificial insemination. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 14 degrees in Sydney, 8 degrees in Canberra, 11 degrees in Melbourne and 14 degrees in Perth.